Hi, we are IITB Mars Rover team, an undergraduate student team of over 40 space enthusiasts dedicated to the design and development of Mars Rover prototypes. Following our learnings from previous competition, we are thrilled to unveil our 2023 rover.
This year, the team has aimed to go a notch above and beyond all our previous iterations, from introducing 7 degrees of freedom in the robotic arm, setting up a bi-channel communication network, and developing a completely independent onboard bioassembly subsystem. We have introduced upgrades across all subsystems.
The current suspension is a lightweight rocker bogey design with a 6-wheel drive.
The suspension links are cut from square aluminium alloy pipes and provide a robust base for extreme terrain traversal and obstacle climbing. The suspension parameters have been optimized for transverse slope traversal of up to 40 degrees with a novel four-bound mechanism that attaches to the chassis externally. The drive uses kit steering for seamless operation in sharp corners and cramped spaces.
Improving upon last year's iteration, this year we have incorporated chevron-shaped trousers and lightweight chassis.
The wheel design has a custom-built aluminium wheel hub with a rim made using sheet metal bending process. The wheel hub assembly is based on a hex shaft motor that is coupled to the wheel hub using a hex coupler. The spokes have been designed to increase the compliance of the wheels.
After extensive research, we have completely revamped the robotic arm, introducing a 7-degree freedom design for better maneuverability.
Linear actuators and worm gear drive has been used to reduce backlash, improve precision of the end effector, and meet torque requirements to lift heavy weight objects up to 5 kg. The end effector uses a jaw mechanism designed to enhance load bearing and gripping of heavy objects having various shapes and sizes. A linear actuator is used for precise control of the wrist, improving on the previous iteration of the arm. Elbow rotation has been added to create a spherical workspace for the end effector. To solve the problem of wire windup in the end effector, we have added a slip ring on the gripper for continuous rotation.
For the current version, we completely redesigned the bioassembly system, which included modifying the test and adding separate soil collection mechanism.
Our custom soil collection arm has 3 degrees of freedom with a gripper built to carefully collect soil samples. The arm is mounted with temperature, humidity, and methane sensors. Additionally, pH of the soil is tested post-collection. The soil sample is then transported to one of the test modules. The prototype shown has 2 test modules and one site for collection of an uncontaminated sample for further analysis, which will be extended to accommodate 2 more test modules. Each of the 4 individual modules is capable of testing for pH, protein, existence of life, and classification of life as extinct or extinct. We have trained a convolutional neural network to identify and classify rock samples, a custom Raman spectrometer with a turntable mount holding the different samples finalizes the minerals present.
The hardware subsystem has focused on a compact and efficient design for rover mobility, biosystem operation and easy debugging.
Our main onboard processor is the Intel NUC, supported by an RPi 4B+ for additional rover controls. All onboard electronics sit in a neatly housed, fully detachable ELEC box coupled to the rover with aviation-grade connectors. The entire rover runs on a 12-volt rail, down-converted for specific components, powered by a lithium-ion battery pack via a kill switch. To reduce communication blackouts, we have implemented a dual-band communication system using a Ruckus P300 and Rocket M2 module. Ongoing field trials have shown promising results with reliable non-LOS communication of over 1 km. To ease rover operation, we have implemented a Django-based web GUI for consolidated rover controls and visual feedback. A fully mobile pre-configured base station enables a quick setup time of less than 10 minutes and reduces chances of manual errors.
After winning Excellence Award in Autonomous Operation in 2 consecutive international rover challenges, this year's autonomous subsystem focuses on improving reliability and moving towards a level 4 autonomy.
For effective traversal, Rover utilizes GPS data provided by sensors on an Android device using a custom-built APK. With use of an onboard LiDAR sensor and Intel RealSense stereo camera, an occupancy grid is created using RTAB map, which helps in obstacle avoidance and path planning. The rover obtains IMU data from the app for pose estimation and feedback from the wheels for closed-loop velocity control, which helps the rover to pass through a gate and a single post. To search for the Aruko markers, we have implemented quad spinning strategy. The rover recursively performs 360-degree rotations to search for AR tags on the sides of a square. To detect AR tags, we use OpenCV along with querying point cloud data to obtain its position. We have extensively tested rover autonomy on gazebo simulations and multiple on-field trials.
We have spent months preparing for the competition, and in the upcoming days, we will be performing extensive field trials in the competition simulated environment, and hence are confident of a good show in URC 23. This sums up our video submission for URC 23.